Saya ucapkan terima kasih kepada Wabilau kerana mengambil inisiatif ini bersama dengan rakan-rakan. Kui Laiping, Tachai Hao. Saudara Sekretari Le, Nandri Mandekam. Saudara, kita ada barisan pemidato, akademik, politik, sarjana yang terkemuka untuk membantu mengupas persoalan dari tragedi 13 Mei sehinggalah gagasan Satu Malaysia oleh Perdana Menteri Dato' Sri Najib. Kita tidak banyak ruang di negara kita untuk membahaskan tajuk-tajuk sedemikian. Bagi orang Melayu, Cina, India, Iban Kadazan, 13 Mei itu kalau disentuh dan agak salah tafsirannya dari kupasan tafsiran pemimpin UMNO, maka ia boleh dianggap satu jenayah, satu kesalahan, seditious. Tetapi setelah 51 tahun merdeka, mustahil untuk kita dapat beri kuasa atau yang kita sebut pemerkasaan, beri kuasa kepada rakyat kalau rakyat tidak boleh bahas isu yang pokok, belajar dari sejarah, menimba pengalaman sejarah, kemudian memperkuat tekad kita membangun negara kita bersama. Ini bukan slogan politik. Selepas Mei 13, slogannya juga perpaduan. Kemudian timbul gagasan dasar ekonomi baru. Kerana tafsiran itu tentang masalah yang menyebabkan berlakunya insiden 13 Mei salah, maka penyelesaiannya pun penyelesaian yang berunsur perkauman. Saya mewakili pandangan yang tidak ingin menafikan aspek-aspek positif tatkala pemerintah ketika itu mengemukakan gagasan dasar ekonomi baru. Tetapi saya mewakili generasi kedua dan saya percaya generasi ketiga, keempat yang ada di sini akan menerima kenyataan bahawa kalau mahu Malaysia ini perkuatkan muafakat kekeluargaan, maka penyelesaiannya bukan slogan baru. Penyelesaiannya ialah dasar dan program baru yang adil bagi semua rakyat Malaysia. We have initially identified a problem. Now the solution proposed by the past prime ministers, after once you are passed, the entire slogan and policy is also considered dead. It's just like Islam Habari. You don't hear these days. Very soon, you tend to forget about it. But we have talked about Rukun Negara. We have talked about Wawasan 2020. And now we're talking about One Malaysia. We are not here to champion and promote a new slogan. We are here to define our role as citizens. We are here to respect principles enshrined and guaranteed by our constitution, that this country must promote policies and programs that will help resolve the problems of the poor and the marginalized of all races and ethnic groups of this country. I'm a Malay. I'm a committed Muslim. And I represent a common sentiment that I believe is shared by many Malays and many Muslims. Yes, we want a fair deal for the Malays, not the rich Malays, but the vast majority of the Malays who are still poor and consider themselves ignored and marginalized. And we want a solution that will protect the interests of the Malays together with their brothers and sisters, the Chinese and Indians in this country. Now for that, people like me, Dato' Sri Nizam, our new, I call him the Bendahara Tun Perak. Smart, articulate, and represent the new thinking, the new Malay. Not racist, not dogmatic, very Malay, very Islamic, but very Malaysian and committed to champion the cause of our Malaysians. Now the Perak fiasco, Bar Council President is here, Dato' Sri Nizam also here, and of course, our great veteran politician Lim Kit Siang is here. I don't mean to rival him like this. And a remarkable judge with a remarkable, impressive credentials, Dato' N.H. Chan. So let them deal on the specific issue of great interest to all Malaysians at length. But suffice for me to say that this is not a legal issue that can be hoped to be resolved in the court of law. You know my view about the relevant and irrelevant judge. And that is why our common resolve, representing leaders and supporters of Pakatan Raya, is to demand fair and free elections in the state of Perak now. Saya nak tanya soalan kepada kawan saya, Datuk Seri Najib, Perdana Menteri. Yang takut sangat pilihan raya sebab apa? Ada masalah. Ada masalah undang-undang, ada masalah tafsiran, ada masalah masing-masing mendakwa punya kekuatan. Perak 3 bulan belum tentu siapa pimpin. Kita iktiraf Datuk Seri Nizam, Menteri Besar yang sah. UMNO iktiraf Datuk Seri Zamri, Menteri Besar yang haram. Penyelesaiannya bukan di istana, bukan di mahkamah, tetapi di Mahkamah Rakyat yang akan memutuskan.